Good morning. Today we are going to start first lecture of e-learning for course auditing 1. In this chapter or in this lecture we are going to continue discussing chapter 2, the auditor. Let's remember what we discussed before in course in this course. First we discussed chapter 1, and then in chapter 1 we discussed the definition of auditing, generally accepted auditing standards, the difference between auditing and accounting, and also we discussed the limitation of audit. In chapter 2, we discussed the code of ethics and how you can be an auditor in Egypt. Okay, today we are going to discuss the rest of code of ethics, and specifically we are going to discuss professional skepticism and the responsibilities of the auditor. النهاردة أول محاضرة لنا في كورس audit 2 في التعليم عن بعد. هندرس في المحاضرة دي بداية جزء بقية chapter 2. Chapter 2 بيتكلم عن الأوديتور. خلونا نفتكر مع بعض احنا درسنا ايه في الكورس ده قبل كده. احنا درسنا في الكورس ده قبل كده chapter 1, وفي chapter 1 عرفنا definition of audit و difference between audit and auditing and accounting و limitation of audit و generally accepted auditing standards, ودرسنا في chapter 2 ال code of ethics, وعرفنا what is the meaning of independency and what is the meaning of objectivity and what is the meaning of due care. Okay, في الشاب في المحاضرة دي أو في الليكتشر دي احنا هندرس بقية الكود اوف اسكس, وهندرس أهم حاجة تكون عند المراجع اللي هي البروفيشنال سكبتاتيزم, بلس ان احنا هنعرف ايه هي responsibilities او الثري مين responsibilities للأوديتور اللي المفروض يتحملها الأوديتور. Okay, let's start our lecture with professional skepticism. Professional skepticism. What is the meaning of professional skepticism? Professional skepticism meaning you have a doubt. انك عندك شك. You don't suppose that the management of the client is honest or dishonest. انت ما بتفترضش ان هم امناء او صريحين معك في المعلومات اللي بيدوها لك او غير امناء. لا. It's a state of mind that helps auditor remain objective. هي حاجة في العقل بتخليك دايما objective, and requires a questioning mind and a critical assessment of evidence. You don't accept any evidence that you gather or accumulate from the management or from the client as its correct evidence. You have to make a critical assessment. انت ما بتقبلش اي ايفيدنس جايه لك من العميل او انت جمعتها على انها صحيحه, لا انت لازم تعمل لها نظره انتقاديه او critical review او نظره فحص انتقادي. While working closely with management and other corporate employees, auditors must maintain an attitude of professional skepticism when they evaluate information from and about the people they deal with on a daily basis. The auditor have working with the management or working with the corporate employers. Okay, this working with closely, this meaning he maybe have a relationship with the management. Okay, this relationship may be making an objective, or maybe make him believe they are honest and believe every statement they give to him. Okay, so when you are working, you don't supposed to believe in every evidence on every statement you have from the management. No, you have to keep professional skepticism. لازم تفضل عندك حالة شك في ان كل المعلومات اللي هما بيدوها لك ممكن تكون مش صحيحة. خلاص. But professional skepticism requires a balanced view of people and organization and is based on the assumption that management is neither honest nor dishonest. يبقى احنا هنا بنفترض, we as an auditors, we suppose that the management honest or dishonest until evidence proves otherwise. يبقى احنا بنفترض هنا ان احنا حتى as an auditors we don't believe in honesty or dishonest of the management. We have to accumulate evidence that supports the honesty or dishonesty of the management. لازم نجمع evidence تثبت ان هم honest ولا dishonest. And otherwise you have evidence that the management is honest. So you have to give an opinion that the management is based on the evidence you accumulate and based on the critical assessment of the evidence you accumulate. Okay, يبقى إذن إحنا هنا as an auditor we should work with professional skepticism. Professional skepticism هو state of mind that help auditors remain objective. هي حاجة عقلية, شك على طول احنا كأوديتورز عندنا حالة شك ان كل المعلومات اللي احنا بنجمعها ممكن تكون غير دقيقة او غير صحيحة. خلاص، طول ما انت بتفكر او عندك professional skepticism as an auditor all the time you have to have skepticism. If you have skepticism this means you are remain objective. Okay, professional skepticism consists of two primary components: questioning mind and the critical assessment of audit evidence. يبقى احنا عشان نعمل professional skepticism لازم اعمل حاجتين، لازم يبقى عندي questioning mind، عقل بيسأل طول الوقت، عقل ما بيفترضش ان الحاجة اللي هو واصل لها صح او الحاجة اللي هو شايفها قدامه صح، and the critical assessment of the audit evidence. وعلى طول طول الوقت كل evidence انت بتجيبها لازم تعمل لها critical assessment او تقييم نقدي او فحص نقدي. يبقى as an auditor to make or to do professional skepticism you have to have question mind, a mind that always ask. You don't believe in every statement or every evidence you accumulate without critical assessment. من غير critical review, without questioning if this evidence is correct or not. Okay? طيب. This is professional skepticism. يبقى professional skepticism state of mind that keep auditors objective, contained from two main components, questioning mind and the critical assessment of evidence. Let's see what is the responsibilities of the auditor. The auditor have three primary responsibilities related to the conduct of audit. عنده ثلاث مسؤوليات أساسية مرتبطة بأداء عملية المراجعة. To plan the audit so as they have reasonable assurance that errors and fraudulent misstatements will be detected and corrected. To evaluate the potential for illegal acts on the part of the client. Three, to evaluate the likelihood that the company will contain as a going concern. Let's discuss the three of the three responsibilities. First one, to plan the audit so as to have reasonable assurance that errors and fraudulent statements will be detected and corrected. نفتكر لما كنا بنقول the objective of the auditing. The objective is the auditing to give a reasonable assurance that financial statements are free from material misstatements. This is the main objective of the auditor, of the auditing process. الهدف الأساسي من عملية المراجعة أو auditing process إن أنا أجيد أدي reasonable assurance that financial statements are free from material misstatements. وقلنا الكلمة دي أو الستيتمنت دي تفضل في بالنا على طول، إن الأوديتور لازم يدي reasonable assurance، وإن هو بيدي reasonable assurance not absolute assurance that financial statements are free from material misstatements. إن القوائم المالية كلها financial statements, balance sheet, income statement, cash flow statements free from material misstatements، مفيهاش أي أخطاء جوهرية. يبقى first objective to give a reasonable assurance that the financial statements are free from material misstatements. Okay, this is the first responsibility. Second responsibility, to evaluate the potential for illegal acts on the part of the client. Okay, the third responsibility, to evaluate the likelihood that the company will contain as going concern. He have to evaluate that the company is going to contain, not have a failure or financial distress. Let's discuss first responsibility, to plan the audit so as to have reasonable assurance that errors and fraudulent misstatements will be detected and corrected. Okay. Audit responsibilities. First responsibility, to plan the audit so as to have a reasonable assurance that errors and fraudulent misstatements will be detected and corrected. Reasonable assurance for an audit engagement is defined as a high but not absolute. As we said, he gave reasonable assurance, not absolute assurance. Level of assurance expressed positively in the auditor's report as the reasonable assurance that the information subject to the audit is free from material misstatements. This is the meaning of audit responsibility. Audit responsibility number one, the first, the main objective of auditor, to give reasonable assurance. We said why auditor give reasonable assurance, not absolute assurance, because he working with sampling. He don't give an auditing for the whole population. He only audit a sampling, reasonable sampling, and with the result of the sampling, he expected that the audit the population is the same result. احنا قلنا ليه الاوديتور بيدي ريزنبل اشورنس او تاكيد نسبي، لان احنا قلنا ان هو بيشتغل بالسامبلنج، يعني ما بيراجعش البوبوليشن كله او مجتمع المراجعه كله، خلاص هو بيراجع نسب ريزن سامبل بيراجع سامبل، والسامبل دي مفروض انها representative سامبل، يعني معنى ذلك ان النتيجة اللي هيوصلها من السامبلينج دي هتقدر تعبر عن نتيجة كل المجتمع. هو بيدي level of assurance، بيدي reasonable assurance، والreasonable assurance دي مفروض ان هو بيعبر عنها في الاودت ريبورت. والاودت ريبورت احنا هندسكس الاودت ريبورت من more details in chapter 5. الانفورميشن سبت تو اوديتس از فري فروم ماتيريال ميس ستيتمنت، فري فروم ماتيريال ميس ستيتمنت يعني مفيش فرودلنت ميس ستيتمنت، او لو كان في فرودلنت ميس ستيتمنت هي ديتكتد ذس فرودلنت اند ميكينج كوركشن اند ميك ذا مانجمنت كوركت ذس ميس ستيتمنت. ليتس سي وين ذا اوديتور فايند ذات ذير از ا ماتيريال ميس ستيتمنت فاينانشال ستيتمنت، هي هاف ذا فيرست ديسيجن هي از جوينج تو تيك، هي جيف a hint to the management, he gives the information to the management that there is a material misstatement in financial statement and waiting from the management to correct this material misstatement. Okay, if the management corrected these material misstatements, then the author is going to give you unqualified opinion, a clean opinion, or he's going to say that the financial statement are free from material misstatements. So what if the management rejected to making a modification or making correction for this misstatement? Then the author have to give an opinion, a qualified opinion, adverse opinion, or disclaimer of opinion. And we're going to see what is the difference between these three types of opinions. يبقى خلينا نشوف ان الاوديتور مفروض هيطلع ريبورت. لو فجأة اكتشف ان there is a material misstatement في الفاينانشال ستيتمنتس هيعمل ايه؟ عنده اول اوبشن قدامه ان هو هيبلغ الادارة، he's going to inform the management ان في financial statements is not free from material misstatements، وان في material misstatements و fraudulent misstatements in the financial statements. اوكي الادارة have to correct these misstatements، لازم تصلح الاخطاء دي. once ان الادارة صلحت الاخطاء دي، once management corrected this misstatement، then the author is going to give you unqualified opinion or clean opinion. This clean opinion saying that the financial statements are free from material misstatements. Okay. طيب الادارة rejected، الادارة رفضت انها تعمل modification ورفضت انها تعمل correction للmaterial misstatements. يبقى ايه الوضع دلوقتي؟ الوضع ان الاوديتور هيطلع يا اما qualified opinion يا اما adverse opinion يا اما هيعمل disclaimer opinion يمتنع عن ابداء الرأي. وهنشوف شابتر 5 ايه الديفرنس بين ذيس 3 تايبس اوف اوبينيونز، وليه ما يجيش ليه يدي امتى يدي كواليفايد وامتى يدي ادفيرس وامتى يعمل ديسكلايمر اوف اوبينيون. اوكي يبقى ذيس از ذا فيرست ريسبونسبيليتي اند ذيس از ذا مين اوبجكتيف اوف ذا اوديت بروسيس. اوكي ريسبونسبيليتي تو ايفالويت ذا بوتنشال فور الليجال اكتس اون ذا بارت اوف ذا كلاينت، اوديتور سبيند جريت بورشن اوف تايم اوف ذا تايم بلانينج اند بيرفورمينج اوديت تو ديتكت ان انتشنال ميستيكس. Unintentional mistakes, we are going to find it that unintentional mistakes equal errors, but intentional mistakes that fraud that we discussed in the first responsibility. Unintentional هي الأخطاء غير المقصودة دي أو المستيكس غير المقصودة دي بنسميها أخطاء، لكن الintentional mistakes دي بنسميها fraud اللي احنا مفروض الأوديتور اكتشفها فيه أو كانت first responsibility. يبقى unintentional mistakes made by management and employers. Auditors find a variety of errors resulting from such things as mistakes in calculation, omissions, misunderstanding, and misapplication of accounting standards, incorrect summarizations and depreciations. اللي بيحصل ان الاوديتور في بعض الاحيان ال employers او الaccountants بيكون عندهم misstatements معينة in unintentional mistakes. ممكن تكون في الكالكوليشن نفسها في الحسابات، ممكن يكون بالخطأ عمل اوميشن حذف او عمل سوء تقدير مس اندرستاندينج او سوء فهم للاكاونتنج ستاندردز ومس ابلكيشن ليها، او مثلا عمل سمرايزيشنز او نقل لما بيجي يعمل بوستنج مثلا في الليدجر مثلا ممكن يعمل اوميشن او ينقل غلط. فكل الحاجات دي الاوديتور لازم يعمل ايفالويشن ليها. يبقى in sometimes accounting or accountant make some mistakes in calculation, maybe cancel some of information by mistake, not it's unintentional, not intentional mistakes, maybe have misunderstanding of accounting standards, specifically when these standards are new one، لما يكون في standards لسه جديدة بنطبقها new accepted standards، فبالتالي بالنسبة له بتبقى صعب ان هو يفهم يطبقها ازاي. مثلا when he making a posting from ledger to try to from journal to ledger. ممكن يعمل missing some information. Okay, this is one responsibility from the auditor. He have to evaluate the potential for illegal acts. Okay, by the way, this is even its responsibility, but it have a big mistakes, or let's say maybe auditor can't detect these misstatements, or can't detect these unintentional mistakes. Why? Because it's not affect the balance of the trial balance. Some mistakes can be discovered, can be detected when it's affected the trial balance, the balance of the trial balance. But what if the debit and credit are the same amount, are the same value? There is no imbalance. The trial balance is not balanced, or there is no mistake in the balance of the trial balance, and the auditor can discover these misstatements. It's need more tasks, need more tests from the auditor. في بعض الأحيان الأوديتور ما بيقدرش يكتشف المستيكس دي. ليه؟ لأنها ما بتأثرش على البالانس اوف ذا ترايل بالانس، ما بتأثرش على توازن الترايل بالانس. الديبت ايكوال كريدت، سو ذا بالانس از اوكي. فبالتالي هو ما بيقدرش يكتشف الأخطاء دي، بتبقى صعبة عليه، بس هو ممكن يكتشفها بمور تيستس ومور تايم تو فايند ذيس مستيكس. اوكي، لأنها هتضطر تخليه يرجع، يو هاف somehow we have to come back to the first transaction. يرجع على أول معاملة حصلت قبل ما نسجل الجورنال والليدجر والترايل بالانس. اوكي، responsibility of the auditor to evaluate the likelihood that the company will contain as a going concern. As a part of engagement, the auditor evaluates the ability of the organization to contain as a going concern over the next year. The goes من الكونتراكت اللي ما بين this is the part of the contract between the auditor and the client. The auditor must give an opinion whether the company is going to contain for the next year, for the next 12 months. Okay, generally auditors focus on several key issues when evaluating whether there is a substantial doubt about the entity ability to contain as going concern. Auditors consider the ability of organization to generate sufficient cash flows to meet obligations by evaluating liquidity ratio and cash flow projections. If the weight of evidence is such that the auditor has substantial doubts that the company can survive the next 12 months, an explanatory paragraph is added to the auditor's opinion describing the conditions leading to this determination. Okay. جزء من الكونتراكت او جزء من التعاقد اللي ما بين الانجيجمنت، الارتباط اللي ما بين الاوديتور والكلاينت، ان الاوديتور هاف تو جيف هيز اوبينيون اباوت جوينج كونسرن، اذا كانت الشركه هتكمل لل 12 مانس الجايين ولا لا. هو بيشوف قدره الشركه على انها جينيريت كاش فلو، الكاش فلو ده عشان تقدر تدفع بيها الاوبليجيشنز او اللايبيلتيز اللي عليها. وبالتالي هو بيعمل evaluating للliquidity ratios، وبيعمل evaluating للcash flow projections. تمام؟ اوكي، هو عمل evaluation دي وبدأ يجمع evidence، والevidence بدأت تظهر له ان لأ في مشكلة، او ان في expectations او في doubts. البروفيشنال سكبتاتيزم بقى، وان هو عنده doubts ان في مشكلة، وان الشركة ممكن ما تكملش بكرة، او ممكن ما تفضلش شغالة لمدة ال 12 شهر الجايين. ففي الحالة دي لازم هيصدر unqualified opinion with explanatory paragraph. هيصدر حاجة اسمها رأي unqualified مع فقرة توضيحية يقول فيها انا عندي reasonable doubts ان ممكن الشركة ما تكملش السنة الجاية او 12 months الجايين. ليه؟ عشان عندها مثلا مشكلة في liquidity، او عندها مشكلة في انها تعمل تدفع مثلا اللونج تيرم، او تدفع الشورت تيرم لايبيلتيز اللي عليها، او عندها مشكله في انها جينيريت الكاش فلو اللي هيدفع الشورت تيرم لايبيلتي. خلاص، يبقى اذا هو عنده من احد اسباب الارتباط، او من احد الحاجات اللي الستيك هولدرز او الستوك هولدرز بيدوروا فيها في الريبورت، ان الريبورت ما يكونش فيه باراجراف بيقول ان ممكن الشركه يكون عندها بروبلم في السنه الجايه او في التو نيكست 12 مانثس انها تكمل. يبقى as a contract أو as a part of contract أو engagement between the auditors and the client is the auditors if he have any doubts about the financial statements from the financial statement from the information and the evidence he gathered from the liquidity ratio and cash flow projections of the financial statements show that there is a problem in the company to generate cash flow to meet its obligation and short-term liabilities, then the auditor have to issue and report with explanatory and qualified report with explanatory paragraph. In this paragraph, he tell that he have a doubt that the company is going to contain for the next 12 months. These doubts build on or he find out or he discover this doubt or he find out this doubt or he have these doubts because of the evidence he accumulated, and he should show his evidence. He should say, I have doubts because, for example, there is a problem in the liquidity ratios, there is a problem in for the payment for the short-term liabilities, there is a problem in generating cash flow. He expecting from this evidence or from these indicators that the company is not going to contain for the next year. Okay, from this point, in this point, we are going to finish our chapter and we are going to finish our lecture. Okay, next lecture, we are going to discuss chapter 2, the auditee. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the client. As we said before, in audit 1, we first have an interest for the auditing, with knowing what is the meaning of auditing and the difference between the auditing and the accounting. In chapter 2, we know who is the auditor, who's the one who doing the audit process, and in chapter 3 the whom the auditor going to make the audit process, and in chapter 4 we discuss the audit process steps, and chapter 5 we are going to discuss an audit report, and in this and by this chapter 5 we saying as an auditors we finished our job and this is our opinion. Thank you.